Hello to everyone watching this footage. It's Leviathan here again, and I've got another story. This one is going to involve the fourth member of the Scantily Six team and a notable enemy of Madame Shear. And this one might be a bit more interesting to you guys when it comes to its new aspects. And bear with me as I read the storyline, and hopefully you guys could be able to tag along and pay attention and such. Here we go. Mother Hornet number 1, The Beginning, created and copyrighted by Levi Corsi Ames, July 23rd, 2015. To begin the story, we start traveling across the depths of space until we start noticing a swarm of starships that resemble hornets. In the main room of the main starship, we see a feminine queen that resembles an insectoid. She has compound blue eyes, black and white hair, and a short bob, is dressed in a set of latex clothes with black and yellow stripes, and possesses a pair of insect antennae and wings. This story is particularly about her. Her name is Queen Buzanix, or simply Mother Hornet. She was examining the frontal window until they finally located Earth. Finally, our travels complete. Me and my Stuntrian army shall destroy humanity and mark it as a place for our kind to flourish. Prepare for landing, she said as her servants followed her commands. Meanwhile, back in New York City, we see Madame Shear having a video chat with James Maxwell, having a romantic time. Suddenly, her main computer system, Maya, appeared and announced, Sir, we have some invaders. An insectoid queen known as Mother Hornet has arrived with her armies from Stuntrinth to expand their territory, and in doing so, they are attempting to destroy all humanity. Okay then, Maya. Prepare the transporter, Kim replied. Eventually, Buzanix and her armies arrived in New York City and started attacking the locals. After a time of bloodshed, Madame Shear finally arrived at the scene. Mother Hornet, you shall not try to annihilate mankind, she yelled at her. Well, if it isn't what the locals call Madame Shear, in case you didn't know yet, you'll regret trying to dethrone an interstellar queen. And after saying that, Kimberly slapped her across the face, urging her to summon both her soldiers and a swarm of wasps to attack her. After Shear defeated them, Buzanix flew to her general direction and started stabbing Shear with the retractable stingers on the back of each of her hands. Right before she finished her off, Buzanix heard a loud, Hey! As she realized that Denstrini arrived to save Shear. Oh, that's just gross. What kind of organism are you? Hornet yelled in disgust. Due to her newly formed nausea, Mother Hornet was unable to fight back, as she was being throttled, impaled, and shot by the heroic Denstrini. After her gruesome defeat, she and her armies retreated into their starships and flew out of sight. When Denstrini helped Madame Shear up, she asked her, What was it about me that was grossing her out so much? Well, Denstrini, I think that since she's half Hornet, she's unable to see the color red. I believe she had a perfect view of your insides. That was interesting, Debbie said sarcastically as she helped her back at her home and workplace, Blader Tech Tower. However, Mother Hornet and her servants decided to travel to the jungles of Africa, where they made a new headquarters that was since called the Hive Out. A while later, Buzanix was contacted and hired by the villainous Tyranitar to become a new member of the slowly constructing Scantily Six, which is the official villain team against the heroic Madame Shear. The end. I hope you guys were interested in that installment for that character, and I hope you guys bared with me when I was just trying to make sure to have the story comprehensible and such. And if you guys want, it's your choice. You could be able to like, comment, and subscribe down below. It's your choice. And until next time, it's Leviathan. Hope you guys enjoy your times. Hope you guys enjoyed this footage. And until next time, in transmission.